have equivalence PhD dissertation, you are patterns for K-means clustering. Tiedekunnan määränä kustoksena julistan tilaisuuden alkaneeksi.
Clustering aims at putting similar objects in same groups and different objects in different groups. The objects are typically points in space. Like in this figure, there are some points, and to determine how it's clustered, we have the location in space. Just the similarity of these points. And there are many uses of clustering, for example, image quantization, workload balancing, location-based application, and many others. Like in this figure, we have picture color values, and we have quantized those values to say storage space nearly optimally by clustering. And here's one application, is the workload balancing. Suppose the transport company has to deliver freight to different locations, and they have several cars. First, these locations are clustered, so that one car gets one cluster to deliver. And this, by this way, we can get a shorter road for the cars. And we start with the data set. Consisting of points in space, and you can think how many different ways there are to cluster the data set with a certain number of clusters. And even in this small size of data set, the number of different clusterings is huge. And for example, this data set of 50 points, there are this many different ways to cluster this. In this case, three clusters. So we need a suboptimal fast algorithm to do clustering. It is not possible to go through all these different ways to cluster and check which is the best cluster. We need to have a an algorithm to do this task. And, clustering is classified this way. This one example. The main classes are hierarchical clustering and partitional clustering, and those are then divided into several subclasses. And my dissertation deals with partitional clustering. Publications 1, 2, and 4 squad error clustering, and publications 3 and 5 graph theory clustering. And now I'll go to the authors of the publications, the contribution. In publication 1, I express the total squared error, this is the most often used criterion of clustering. I express it by analytic function. And because the analytic function can be derived, and standard optimization methods can be used to minimize that function. And we minimize a function, you get to the local optimum point, so that we get as good as possible clustering as a result. And it turns out that this doing clustering this way is not so time consuming. We have a linear time complexity for calculating the approximation of total squared error. We have a linear time complexity calculating the gradient of that function. And in the last line, we see that if we compare to typical K-means iteration, it is almost the same time complexity. An experimental results correspond to those of K-means, it gives quite similar result. And then in publication 2, this is a new way of doing clustering. We first produce an initial structure. For example, here we have a line structure. We have k points here in space. Those are the initial centroids, the representatives of clusters. And then we force all the points of the dataset into these points, these point locations. Evenly, so every point has, every central location has many points as others, and randomly, so that every location is as likely as any other. And then this algorithm starts to move these data points, which are now in this structure, starts to move the data points towards the original data set. And here we have the first step. Now the points have a little bit moved. Second step, moved further. And within each step, we do k-means clustering for these centroids, so that centroid locations remain good during the whole algorithm running. And now we continue this algorithm. Centroids remain good, and at last we have come to the original data set, and we see that the centroid locations are in optimal place. So in this case, this algorithm gave good result. And to compare this algorithm to some algorithms found from literature, we see that it's clearly better than normal k-means, and better than k-means plus plus, and it competes with repeated k-means. Question number 3. We rely on Huygens theorem, it says that pairwise squad distances within cluster equals to number of points times total squad error. And in this Cascade cross function, we write this into for every cluster. And we have here TSC and number of points multiplied. And the next line, it says the TSC to MSC. We get one N out from this TSC. So there's now N squared. And because the number of the sum of n's equals to total number of points, we can see that this forced function tends to balance clusters. And also experimental results show that this S-cut gives good both FSC and balance. So the balance is how equal the number of points in its cluster is. And then publication number four. I come back to this this figure where we had this delivery problem. This algorithm can be used in this solving this problem. How we do it? We give cluster slots and calculate distances from these clusters to every data point. We square it, and then we solve the assignment problem by Hungarian algorithm. And this assignment is same phase as in K-means assignment phase. Otherwise the algorithm is the same as K-means. And we can see here in the top left that balanced K-means gives always perfect balance. And the MSC is still reasonably good. And then publication number five. We can construct minimum spanning tree of a graph, Euclidean distance graph, fast. And type of for calculating this faster is this n to the power of 1.5 compared to the exact construction with this n to the power of 2. So there is the speed increase. And this MST can then be used in clustering also, and you can see that using this fast MST doesn't have the effect much in the clustering result. It gives almost the same clustering as the exact MST. I ask you, honorable professor, as the appointed opponent, to present those remarks that you consider my thesis required.